Hello everyone. Welcome to my chair yoga class today. I hope everyone is staying healthy and keeping active physically and mentally. This chair class is a great way for you to do both. So it involves a little coordination. We're gonna challenge our balance and build some gentle strength. So we're gonna be using a chair as a prop today. And the chair I have is a folding chair, and it's pretty light, so I can move it from side to side. If you do not have a chair like this, no worries. You can use whatever chair you have. You can even use a recliner. We're going to be sitting toward the back of it, and then we'll be perching toward the front when we're a little more active in the class. And if it's not a chair that you can pick up and move, then you're just going to move your body around the chair. So no worries. I will try to cue you accordingly. So you might want to have a couple props available, one being a yoga strap. You could, if you don't have a yoga strap, you could use a long towel or a belt. That would work great. You could also use a yoga block, and if you don't have one of these, grab a thick book. That'll work just fine for our purposes. And you can just place that right in front of your feet, and I'll cue you as it's needed. So to start out here, we're just gonna sit toward the back of our seat. So you can go ahead and just come all the way back so that your back is actually touching the back of your seat. And then you can bring that block or book so that it's right beneath your feet if you wanna bring the floor closer to you. You don't have to use it. Props are just, they're helpful. So it's nice to have them around to aid you to make your practice feel better in your body, but certainly don't have to use them. But if you do have them around, keep them handy. So just coming to that comfortable beginning corpse pose with the prop beneath your feet if you like, or pushing it away if you don't. We're just gonna start to come into our breath. We're gonna take our shoulders down away from our ears. Hands can rest right on our lap. And we'll start to take that breath in through our nose. And we can also release it out through our nose. If you're feeling like there's a little heat in there and you need to release it, then by all means, release it through your mouth. So spending a few moments just tuning into our breath. Maybe checking in with our thoughts. If our mind is busy right now, we're going to acknowledge the thoughts that we're experiencing. And then we're just going to set those thoughts aside and come back to our breath. And just allowing our breath to expand. You can imagine that your belly is filling up like a balloon as you inhale, and then imagine that balloon depleting as you exhale. We'll take one more breath in. Forward so that we're seated right on the edge of our chair. And from here, we're just going to come into a seated mountain. So shoulders are back and down away from our ears. Arms are along our sides, palms facing out. Let's take a breath in and circle sweep arms up. As we exhale, hands can come to heart center. Let's take a breath here. And as we exhale, let's gently twist toward your right. bring your gaze over your right shoulder. Just easing your body into this first twist. Continuing to breathe in and out. We'll take another inhale. And as we exhale, we'll come back to the center. Let's release our arms, give them a little shake. And then sitting up nice and tall, inhaling circle, sweeping arms up. Exhaling hands to heart center. Let's take another breath in. And bring that same twist to our left. Again, allowing our gaze to ease over our left shoulder. We'll take another breath in. Exhale, we'll come back to the center. Let's shake our arms out again. And let's just find a few circles with our shoulders. And let's take those circles in both directions. And then taking our hands right to our lap, let's inhale and bring our gaze toward the ceiling, coming into a cow. Exhaling, chin comes in toward our chest as we round our mid back for cat. And then inhaling back to cow. Exhaling into cat. And just flowing here a few more times. Just continuing to link our movement with our breath. Allowing some lubrication for our whole spine. And then coming back to that seated mountain, let's do a little chair version of a sun salutation. So we're just gonna sit up nice and tall, inhaling, circle sweeping arms up. Exhaling, let's swan dive down to a forward fold. You can rest your chest right on the top of your thighs if that's okay for you. And you can allow your head to be nice and heavy here. So allowing the crown of your head to face the floor. We'll take a couple breaths here. Out, reverse swan diving up. Hands come to heart center. We'll take another breath in and out. And then on our next inhale, let's take our right knee into our chest, sitting up nice and tall. Let's take a breath here. And as we exhale, we can release that right leg and bend our knee a couple times. And then placing that right foot on the floor, sitting up nice and tall, inhaling, circle sweeping arms up. Exhaling, swan diving down to our seated forward fold once again, allowing your head to be heavy. Allowing for a little space in your cervical spine. Maybe nodding your head yes and no. And then with arms out, dropping our hips, reverse swan diving up. We'll take hands to heart center as we exhale. Take a breath in. And out. Arms can come to our sides. On our next inhale, let's go ahead and take that left knee in toward our chest again, sitting up nice and tall. Might want to find a few ankle circles here. And then let's release that left leg, bend the knee a couple times. And we can set our left foot on the floor. So sitting up nice and tall, inhaling, circle, sweeping your arms up. Exhaling, swan, diving down to forward fold. We'll take a breath here. And release it. And then let's take our right hand and either bring that to the floor or to our prop if we're using one, which again is just to help bring that floor closer to us. And we're gonna bring a gentle twist to our left. So bringing your left hand to your left thigh is fine. You can bring the back of your left hand and press it into the small of your back and press your left shoulder toward the ceiling. Maybe your gaze eases toward the ceiling with it. You can also take that left hand and reach those fingertips toward the ceiling. So we'll take a breath here. And then releasing that on the exhale, coming back to our forward fold. Let's take a moment. Again, checking in with your head and neck. And then with arms out, dropping your hips, reverse swan diving up. We'll take hands to heart center. Take a breath in. And release it out. And then sitting up nice and tall, just bringing that twist to the other side, inhaling, circle sweeping arms up. Exhaling, swan diving down to our seated forward fold. We'll take a breath. And release it. And then taking your left hand and pressing it into the block or pressing it right into the floor, twisting to your right. Right hand comes to your right thigh. And we can stay right here, or we can take the back of our right hand, press it into the small of our back, raise that right shoulder toward the ceiling along with our gaze. We can even take our right fingertips and reach them toward the ceiling. So taking a breath here. And one more for good measure. And then as we exhale, coming back to our seated forward fold, let's just take a breath here. And release it out. And then arms out, pressing your bottom into your seat, reverse swan diving up. We'll exhale as we take our hands to heart center. And take a breath in. And out. And then checking in with our ankles, just making a few circles, getting them ready to support our body. Before we stand up, let's just do a few windshield wipers. So staying perched at the edge of your seat, we can take our knees in one direction and then the other. We can link this movement with breath if we want. Inhaling center, exhaling to the side. We can also do, I like to call them old-fashioned windshield wipers. Just bringing a little movement into our hips. All right, and then coming to standing, we're gonna take our chair and I guess I didn't mention, I do have my chair on a yoga mat. You can use a yoga mat if you don't have one at home, no worries. We just don't wanna be slipping around too much. So I like to set up my chair at one end of my mat. And then let's go ahead and just face our chair, but let's allow about an arm's length of distance between us and our chair. So we're gonna find a standing mountain now. So I always like to build my standing mountain from the floor up. So really suctioning my feet into the surface beneath me, spreading my toes. Not locking your knees, keeping a little micro bend there. And then bringing shoulders back and down. And then checking in with our jaw. Mountain pose along with forward fold. Downward facing dog also. They're all good foundational poses. So good poses to come come back to as a place to check in. So once we get comfortable in our mountain, we're going to take 5 breaths in and out. And then on our next inhale, we're going to circle sweep arms up. As we exhale, we're going to sit down into a standing chair. So we can imagine that we have a block between our knees, arms are out in front of us. We could also take hands to our hips. We can also bring hands to heart center. So modifying however we feel we need to. But hanging on to this chair for another breath. And then as we exhale, tipping forward into a forward fold. So we did the seated forward fold. Now we're going to do the same thing standing. So again, keeping that little bend in our knees, allowing your head to be heavy. Forward folds are a great chance for us to get that heavy head off of our neck and shoulders to allow gravity to do some good work. We can find some gentle nods, yes and no here. We can hold on to opposite elbows if we like. Bringing a little more weight to the pose. So just taking a couple more moments here. Maybe appreciating the stretch in the backs of our legs. And then with our arms out, dropping our hips, pressing our weight into our feet and our legs, we're going to reverse, swan dive up, and take hands to heart center. And take a breath in, and release it out. Arms can come to our sides. And let's step up a little closer to our chair. We're going to go through a warrior series here. So starting out in that standing mountain, we'll take a breath in. As we exhale, we can step back with our left foot. Now, the beauty of the chair is that we have it there for support. So feel free to take that right hand and just keep it on the chair. So we're going to take our hips and just shift them so that they're facing the chair or facing our mat. And then making sure shoulders are back and down, we're going to circle sweep one or both arms up. Going to keep our focus straight ahead. And take 4 more breaths in and out. 1 more inhale. And as we exhale, let's open that up to warrior two. So we have that right knee over our right ankle, just to protect our joints. And we have our shoulders down away from our ears. If we want to test that, we can take our shoulders up toward our ears and then bring them down. It feels so good. So in this warrior two, we're just going to gaze over our front fingertips. Feel that strength in our legs. We're not dumping into the front too much or the back. We're trying to allow an even distribution of our weight. So one more inhale and exhale here in warrior two. And then let's turn our right palm up and just reverse our warrior, opening up that whole right side of our body. And staying with our breath here. Another inhale, and as we exhale, let's come back to our warrior two. Let's straighten our right leg almost all the way, keeping a little micro bend. Let's lean forward. We're going to come into triangle, so we can place that right hand on our chair, left hand on our hip, and we can stay right here. The idea is that we're going to feel a nice stretch in our hamstrings on the right side. So we're staying here in triangle, or if we want to take it down a little further, we can bring the back of our right hand and just place it along our left, or sorry, our right shin. We can take our left hand and keep it where it's at, or we can reach those fingertips up toward the ceiling. So coming into our triangle. And just breathing. Again, modifying as we need to. If this triangle feels good for you, then stay here. If you want to keep that right hand on the chair, keep it on the chair. So we'll take another inhale. And as we exhale, definitely grab onto that chair and use it to bring yourself out of your triangle to support your lower back. So shaking out our legs a little bit and checking in. Let's go ahead and do the same thing on the other side. So if you have that movable chair, this is where it comes in handy. You can pick it up and move it as you need to. Of course, those of you at home don't really need to move your chair. I need to move mine so that I can see what I'm doing here. Show you my face. So coming back to our standing mountain, let's take a big breath in. And as we exhale, let's step back with our right foot this time. So coming into warrior one on the other side, hips square to your mat, to the chair. And circle sweep arms up, palms facing one another. And we can keep our gaze straight ahead. That left knee is over our left ankle. Jaw stays loose here. Exhale, let's open that up to our warrior two. So left knee still stays stacked over that left ankle. Right foot opens up a little bit so that that back edge is along the edge of your mat. Gaze is soft over those left fingertips. Ceiling. Let's reverse our warrior. Breathe into our left side body. One more inhale. And as we exhale, let's come back to warrior two. Let's straighten our left knee almost all the way, lean forward, and come into triangle on this side. So maybe your hand's resting on the chair, maybe your right hand is on your hip. If you want to come in a little further, you can bring the back of that left hand to the side of your left leg. And of course, pressing our fingertips toward the ceiling if we want. Feel that stretch in the back of our left thigh. Continuing to take that breath in and out. One more inhale. And then as we exhale, let's turn toward that chair, grab onto it, shake those legs out. Let's come into a downward facing dog. So bringing the seat so that it's facing you, or moving so that you are facing your chair's seat. We're gonna stand nice and tall in mountain. We're gonna inhale, circle sweep the arms up. And as we exhale, we'll swan dive down. And we'll bring our hands to our seat. And we're just gonna walk our heels toward the back edge of our mat. So coming into that downward facing dog, utilizing the chair. You can imagine that you're pressing your chest toward the tops of your thighs. can again check in with your head and neck. Maybe just nodding yes and no a few times. Walk our feet a little closer to our chair. We're going to come into a pyramid using the chair here. So let's take our right big toe and bring it behind our left heel. And then we're going to take our right hip and shift it forward, press it forward, left hip presses back. And we can stay right here. If we want to turn this into a little bit more of a balance pose, we can take one hand off at a time. The whole time we're staying with our breath, keeping our thoughts on our practice today. Using this time as a little mental vacation, vacation from our worries. And try lifting each hand off, just seeing how that forces your feet to kind of grip differently onto the floor. And then placing both hands back on your chair, we'll step that right foot up to meet our left and let's shake them both out. And then let's do the same thing on the other side. So we're going to take our left big toe and bring it behind our right heel. We're going to square up our hips, left hip shifts forward, right hip shifts back. And we're just going to breathe here. And if we want to lift one hand up at a time, we can do that. Hands on your seat once again, stepping that left foot up to meet your right, shaking both legs out. And then pressing your weight into your feet, into your legs, arms out, reverse swan diving up. We'll take our hands to heart center. Take a breath here. And exhale, we can bring arms to our sides, shake everything out. And then coming into a little more balance, we're just going to take that chair and we want it to be within reach. So if your chair is stationary, just walk around so that you can grab onto the back of it. So pressing into your right foot, we're just going to bring our left heel and make a little kickstand against that right ankle. But the whole time suctioning that right foot into the ground, building that stability from the ground up, shoulders back and down, jaws loose, and we can stay right here. Maybe that left arm comes out, maybe we raise it up, maybe we take our right hand off of our chair and raise that up too. Gaze can be right in front of us. We could also bring our gaze to the ceiling. If we want a little extra challenge, we can bring that left foot up to our calf. We could even take that left foot to our inner thigh on the right leg. So just finding what works for you, Intree. And staying with your breath. Knowing that that chair is there to support you. If you want even more of a challenge, try closing your eyes here. We'll take another breath in. And as we exhale, we'll slowly come out. you're going, moving around your stationary chair or picking your chair up and moving it to your left hip. We're gonna press our left foot into the floor, find that same kickstand, but with our right heel against our left ankle. Shoulders come back and down away from our ears. And then we can incorporate arms. We can stay right here with our kickstand, with one hand on the chair if we like. Bring that right foot up a little or a lot, just avoiding the knee. So we either want that right foot to be on our ankle, on our calf, or into our inner thigh. So wherever we're at, we're just gonna hang out for a few breaths. Again, ultimate challenge is closing our eyes. Chair to support us. Another inhale. And then exhaling, slowly releasing that, shaking it out. Let's step away from our chair and let's just find a standing forward fold. So standing nice and tall, inhaling circle, sweeping arms up. Exhaling, swan diving down, little bend in our knees here. Coming into that standing forward fold. Again, allowing your head to be nice and heavy, allowing for that space in your spine. Another inhale, and we'll exhale. And then arms out, dropping our hips, reverse swan diving up. We'll take hands to heart center. And release it out. And shake out our arms, shake out our legs. Let's come back to our chair. Find that beginning seated position, but let's stay perched at the edge of our seat. So we're gonna do one more little move here, and then we'll come into a final relaxation. So staying perched at the edge of your seat, let's take our arms out along our sides, palms facing the floor. We're gonna bring our shoulder blades in toward our spine, lifting our chest, belly button presses in toward our spine. We'll take a breath in. And as we exhale, let's just bring our chest toward the floor. So coming into an airplane. We're gonna hang on to this for a breath. And we'll release it out. And then on our next inhale, we'll come back up. And as we exhale, we'll flow back down. So let's do that a few more times, keeping that chest lifted. And we'll inhale, coming back up. And we'll exhale, just releasing that, shaking arms out. So before we come into our seated corpse pose, again, our final relaxation, let's just do some brief neck stretches. So sitting up nice and tall, hands can be at your sides or hands can rest on your lap. We're just gonna take a breath in, and as we exhale, we'll take our chin toward our chest. And we'll just take a few moments here. And we can allow our head to come back up. Let's take another inhale. And as we exhale, let's take our right ear toward our right shoulder. Just a by taking a breath in, and then exhaling, bringing our chin toward our chest. And then allowing your head to come back up. Let's do the same thing on the other side. So taking a breath in, exhaling, left ear eases toward our left shoulder, opening up that whole right side of our neck. And then allowing our head to come back up. Once again, taking a breath in, and then exhaling, bringing our chin toward our chest. And then allowing your head to come back up. And setting yourself up for your final relaxation. So you can go ahead and scoot back into your seat. If you'd prefer, you can lie down on your mat, lie down on the floor. And again, if you have that prop nearby and you want to bring the floor a little closer to you, you can put your feet on that block or book. We're just gonna take our shoulders down away from our ears and just scan our body here at the end of our practice. So starting with your toes and wiggling them. And then allowing your awareness to travel up your legs, over your hips, all the way up to your shoulders, your arms, up your neck, all the way to the top of your head. Wiggle your jaw again. Just taking this time to notice how you feel at the end of your practice. Noticing if your breath feels more expansive, you feel that tingle in your muscles, just that gentle tingle saying that you've done something good for yourself. End with an Apache blessing. I'm sure you've heard it before. May the sun bring you new energy by day. May the moon softly restore you by night. May the rain wash away your worries. May the breeze blow new strength into your being. May you walk gently through the world and know its beauty all the days. Thank you so much for joining me today. Let's all scoot forward in our seats. And then with our arms out, let's take one last breath in, circle sweeping arms up. And we'll exhale, bringing hands to heart center. The light